Taree on the mid-north coast of New South Wales was the host town of this year's Elders Olympic Games. It was their turn to shine once again and show all the young ones how it's done. Video journalist Kris Flanders brings us this story from the Games.
The opening ceremony of the Summer Olympic Games have nothing on the colour or the smiles and pride than those representing their mob in the Elders Olympic Games. Many hours of work and artistic skill went into the banner designs that told everyone just where they're from. The 2015 edition of the Games is one of the largest gatherings ever, and defending champions, the Biripi Sharks from Taree, were glad to be hosting.
This is an important event to Aboriginal people who are aged, frail and disabled. It's where mob comes together and share, catch up, but it's about keeping them independent. They get into training beforehand, they're watching their diet. This is about healthy lifestyle, this is about living longer, you know, and closing that gap.
Mob came from right around New South Wales, and perhaps none further than the Elders from the Blue Mountains, who drove over 8 hours to participate.
First time coming here this season, but we're enjoying ourselves and it's very competitive, but we're having fun.
We left about 6 a.m. and it was 4 degrees, and now we're up here in the tropics and we're just loving it, absolutely loving it. You know, and the best thing about today, organised for Aboriginal people by Aboriginal people, and that is big, it's deadly.
The Elders competing this year proved that age isn't a factor in getting out there and having a go, and there's still plenty of competitive spirits here.
We're from Armidale and Yarralla, Tableland Toppers we're called. I'm very proud of that, to come, you know, represent all my little teeny bobbers and that, and it's good. So they can know that their grands can be, you know, do what the footballers does.
Our young people have football and netball carnivals, but this day belongs to our Elders, and they don't want the Games to ever stop.
A wonderful feeling. I mean, it gets a bit competitive and that's all right, but it's something for us Elders, that we can come and show our skills, and it seems to be getting bigger every year. And it shows our kids where there's a will, there's a way. And to show our kids you can take part in sport, enjoy it, and still be friends. And if you lose, so what?
All teams were decked out in some of the flashiest and deadliest outfits, from all sorts of colours, bright designs, and some with stories representing where they're from.
Our design is from our local auntie, Jenny McEwen, that lives on the Central Coast. She also does a lot of our different artworks for if we want to present to different organisations for a thank you gift. And I believe when we see our Elders having a good time and enjoying themselves, it makes us feel good too.
Pass the ball games tested the Elders, as did the bag toss, along with darts and quoits. But just like in life, they pass with flying colours and their heads held high. Without doubt, the Elders Olympic Games provides much joy to the participants, giving them the chance to compete, catch up with old family and friends, and of course, show off their deadly skills. Kris Flanders, NITV News.